I'm going to tell you a story about something that happened to me. When I was working in the church, one of the reasons why I got kicked out. You know, when you're zealous for the Lord and you're walking on the devil's territory, he don't like it. So he gets you kicked out. There was this Jew, and I'm not prejudiced, that's not what I mean. He was a man, and he was of Jewish descent, so what else do you call him? He came to the place where I was working in the church, and he came to the pastor that was working in that area, and he told him, I'm looking for a wife. Now, I didn't know that he said this. I was working, and I didn't hear him say that. And so, you know, he came to him, and he's being honest, and he told him what he was doing there, and I was single. But I didn't hear him say it. So he came into where all of us ladies were working that day, cleaning up and getting ready for the day. And he came over and he looked at me. I might look like a Jewish person. I don't know. I have dark hair and I have light skin. I don't know. Never thought about it. He walked up to me and he said, are you a Jew? And I ignored him. I didn't know him, so I thought that was kind of a strange question for him to be asking me, so I didn't answer him. So he started talking to some of the other ladies, and he came back to me. Instead of asking me that question, he said, may I touch your hand? And I thought, well, I guess there's no harm in that. So I let him touch my hand, and I had a ring on. If I remember right, it was on my thumb. I don't know. So he pulled that ring off, and he put it on my ring finger, and he goes, well, look at that. It fits. And I said, yeah. He said, well, why do you wear it on the wrong finger? I said, because I'm not married. And he said, well, what is that all over it? I said, it's feet to remind me of all the times that my Lord has carried me and walked with me all the days of my life, which has been many. And then he said, are you a Jew? Well, he's looking at me right in my face now, so I can't ignore him. And I said, sure I am. He goes, you are? I said, yeah, I had a transfusion. He looked at me and he goes, oh, what? I said, yeah, see my scar? And he looked at my arm on my veins and he goes, you had a what? I said, a transfusion. Can't you see that scar? And he's looking at my arm and he's looking at me like, lady, you are a fruit cake. And he looks real close to my arm and he goes, I don't see a scar. And I said, it's there. I had a transfusion and there's a big scar. And he keeps looking at it. He goes, I don't see no scar. I said, yeah, I got a scar just like my master. And then he's starting to catch on. And he kind of gets a goofy look on his face. And he goes, you didn't have no transfusion. I said, yes, I did. I said, aren't you born again? He said, yeah, I'm born again. I said, you really are? Because you're a Jew. Most Jews are not born again. And you're in a Christian church. That kind of makes me wonder, though. He said, yeah, I'm born again. I said, well, I am too. And the day I got born again, I got a transfusion. I got brand new blood. And he just kind of backs up and shakes his head. And he thought, oh, this conversation is over with you, woman. I don't know about you. And he just walks out. He didn't talk to nobody else. He left. And so the pastor he comes over. He was laughing. And he said, what in the world are you talking about? What transfusion did you have that made you a Jew? And I said, well, you're born again. You had a transfusion, too. And he said, you are a nut. What in the world are you talking about? And I said, I was born again. I said, you know, you go to the doctor, and the first thing they want to know every time is, what's the history of your mother, your grandpa, your father, your ancestors? And I said, you know, that don't really apply to me because I'm born again. The day I got born again, I got new blood. Because I am not of this world anymore. I got new blood. I'm born into a new family. That's what born again means. Right? And he looks at me. He said, well, in a way it does. I said, no, that's exactly what it means. It means to be born again. I'm not of this world anymore. That means I got a blood transfusion. I'm not of this kingdom, of this earth, anymore. So whatever diseases whatever that my family line of this world has doesn't apply to me anymore. I am of the bloodline of heaven, not of this earth anymore. And the Bible says that we are kings and princes. So I'm not of this world anymore. I don't have this bloodline anymore. I'm a Jew. I've been grafted in. I've been adopted by the king. He said, but you have to receive that by faith. I said, no, you don't. It doesn't say that. It does not say that. It says you were adopted into the kingdom. I have new blood coursing through my veins. I no longer have the old bloodline. So he said, it is finished. He took on all the curses. He took all the diseases. So why do I have to say that I'm sick when I'm not? Because I don't have that blood anymore. I have new blood. I have a new bloodline. So that's why I call you brother and I call her sister. Because I'm not of this kingdom on this earth any longer. And he just stood there and thought about it. Because he couldn't really deny it. But he was having trouble admitting it because I was right. But you see, it's that kind of talking that got me kicked out of church. Because it's hard to accept. Because I'm zealous for my Lord. And we all should be. Because it messes with your mind. The natural mind can't handle that kind of talk. But I'm a Jew. Because Jesus Christ was a Hebrew. So am I. Because he's my brother. Because Yahweh God is my father. Because I'm born again. I'm born into his kingdom. And I'm not of this world anymore. And I hope you understood what I said. Every time I lay down to try to rest, Father keeps putting this back into my spirit to tell it. So I knew I was supposed to make this video. It's been 3 days now. He keeps reminding me that this happened. And it was not too many weeks after this happened that I was kicked out of the church. There was a lot of things that happened while I worked there. They didn't like me laying hands on people, and they would scream, I'm healed, I'm healed. It wasn't just me, I'm not the only one. But they would scream, I'm healed, I'm healed. Glory, hallelujah, I'm healed. You have to be zealous. And we're in the end times. You can't hide your light in the closet and be of him. You have to show who you are and whose you are, because you're not of this world. It is a fire that's burning in your bones, and it has to come out. And I thank God that I've been able to be on YouTube in the time that I was on Blog Top to talk to all of you and share his word and what he gives me with you. Because I'm not able to do that in the church no more, because they kicked me out. They removed my membership as if I was never there. You know, thank God, Yahweh God, Father doesn't do that to us. He doesn't just get mad at us and strike our name off the Lamb's Book of Life and say, it's as if you were never here. He isn't cruel like people on the earth that gets mad at us because they can't control us. He's not that way. He's a loving God. He loves us. He does not control our thoughts. He loves us to let us have our own thoughts and our own will. Turn your heart to him today. Become zealous for him. You know, there's a song, Paul Wilbur, I think is his name. Oh, Lord, please let that be his name. And he sings in it, I am zealous for him. Be zealous for him today. Don't hide your light. What good is it to hide your light for him or you? Be a bright light for him today. This is Ruby. I am zealous over Zion. I am zealous over Zion. I am zealous over Zion. I will dwell in Jerusalem. She shall be called the city.